In this video here, we're going to learn how to set up our shipping and return settings in Google Merchant Center.
First, let's start with our shipping settings. Open your Google Merchant Center account by going to merchants.google.com. Go to Tools and Settings, Shipping and Returns. Click Add Shipping Service. It's going to ask you your shipping service name. You can name it whatever you like. It won't be seen by shoppers. Select the countries that this service will apply to. You can add as many as you like here. Select the currency that your rates are in. Click Next. It's now going to ask us for our order cutoff time. This is the time where you stop processing orders for the day. We then add in our handling time. This is the period following the cutoff time until the order is actually ready for shipping. The transit time is how long it takes generally to ship the product to the customer. Click Next. Next, it's going to provide us all these different options for how we actually handle shipping with our website. You need to select the correct option for your store and what matches your shipping page and how you actually ship your products. You can also switch the advanced settings to see things like size and weight. Firstly, you can do free shipping over a certain amount. So if someone spends $100, they could get free shipping. So if someone spends $100, you may still charge $15 for shipping. You can select free shipping to ship all your items for free. You can do range based, which means the shipping rate is going to be based on the actual order value. You can also click this button here to have several ranges. So you have tiers for how much your shipping costs depending on the order value. You can also just do flat rate shipping. So every order is shipped for say $20. You can do based on the carrier. So depending on your location, it's going to pull in the carrier services and the pricing for each. Make sure to put in your origin zip code, any percentage adjustments or flat adjustments too. If you need to add a shipping service based on the size or weight of your products, you can click this button here. This allows you to use the advanced settings in the shipping settings. You can then create different shipping rates based on a multitude of factors, based on order price, order weight, number of items, destination. I won't go into too much detail here, but you can play around this for yourself. Honestly, from a business perspective, I do recommend you look into doing free shipping. Once you've chosen your shipping, click save.
I want to offer some advice from a marketing perspective. If you can offer free shipping for your customers, do it. 9 out of 10 shoppers say free shipping is their biggest incentive to shop online. And orders with free shipping have 30% higher average order values. It's becoming a stronger expectation for people as time goes on, with 61% of people saying they're somewhat likely to abandon their cart if free shipping isn't offered. There's no getting around how powerful free shipping can be for your sales. Now let's set up our returns policy in Google Merchant Center.
Next, we need to set up our return policy information. But to start this, we need to make sure we enable the shopping ads in Google Merchant Center. So go to Growth, Manage Programs, and then click Get Started under Shopping Ads. Once you've done this, you now see this page right here, but we can add in our returns information now. Go to Tools and Settings at the top, go back to Shipping and Returns, and you'll now be able to see return policies at the top. Notice here that Google shows an example of how they plan to show your return policy information in Google Ads. Here are the steps to enter when adding your policy. Click Add Policy to start. Add your country. You can add any of the 120 countries listed here to be covered by the policy. Click Next. Add your policy URL. Go to your website and get the URL of your returns and refunds page. Paste it into this box. It's going to ask you, do you accept returns from these countries? If you do, click Yes. If you don't, click No. It's going to ask how customers can return your products. You can say in store, at a kiosk, or by mail. I'm going to put by mail. Here we just add in the actual options for how we actually operate as an e-commerce store. I'm going to put download and print and download and print. Click Next. It's going to ask us how many days do customers have to return the product. You can have a lifetime guarantee or put in a set number of days. I'm going to put in 90 days. You can also extend the return window during certain times of year like the holidays. It's really up to you. I'm going to click Next. It's going to ask you what product conditions that you allow for returns. I'm going to select all in this case. Click Next. It's going to ask what currency applies to this policy. This is for if you're selling to multiple countries with multiple currencies. I would just put in your main currency here. If there's a restocking fee, you can add that in here. There's none for us. It's then going to ask you how much customers will have to pay for return shipping. You can add in your own policy details here. In my case, I'm going to make it free. Click Next. It now shows a summary of what was added, and we can click Done. If you have multiple policies for multiple countries, you can continue adding them in here.
A common problem that I see people making is they'll set up their returns policies in Google Merchant Center and forget to update it once they've updated their actual policies on their website. So keep Merchant Center in mind as the platform where you're officially stating your policies to Google, and to remember to always keep it updated with your business. I'll end this lesson by echoing my earlier advice regarding free shipping. Your shipping and returns policies should be regarded as part of your your marketing. It may be expensive to offer perks such as free shipping or a 90 days no questions asked refund policy. But this is how many businesses have found enormous success. Two famous examples are, one, Zappos, a shoe retailer that offers free shipping and free returns. And two, L.L. Bean, an apparel outlet that had lifetime guarantees on its entire catalog. Stores that we work with tend to have greater success with these customer-friendly approaches by far. Shoppers are incredibly attracted to stores that minimize the risk of a bad experience. And Google knows this. That's why they're asking for this information and putting it on your Google Shopping ads. So guys, that's how we set up our shipping and returns in Google Merchant Center. If you have found this video useful, please hit the like button and let us know down below. This video is also just one of the videos in our free Google Shopping course on our website. It's 100% free, no sign up required. It shows you how to set up, optimize, and scale your Google Shopping campaigns. I'll leave a link down below so you can go and access the rest of the lessons in the course. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.